Okay, so we established that the system was not your friend and you got to stop using the calculator. Because the calculator was introduced early, most people don't know how to do multiplication and division. So what we have to do is go back to the basics. And the basics is the real number set. Everybody's dealt with it. I think they introduce it in grade 6 or 7 and work with it in grade 8 and 9. And what happens is they don't teach it properly. And by the time you graduate, by the time most people graduate, they have no idea how important the real number set is, how the number system is broken down, the number system that you deal with in high school. One thing to consider is, or one thing you should know is, the real number set is just one reality. There are other number sets out there. You just don't deal with them until you go to college or university. So this is the basics. The real number set is the basics, the core of everything you need to learn about mathematics, everything you need to know about mathematics. So we're going to go back to the real number set. The beautiful box that they showed you, and they would ask you questions like, which number sets, which number group does this belong to? Natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, blah, blah, blah. What we're going to do is look at each little section separately and make sure you understand how it's broken up. I'm back. Okay, we're here to talk about the real number set, okay? First thing you gotta do is you gotta make the real number set. So we can take a look at it and look at different sections and understand what it's about. So, clean wall over there. So I'm gonna go at it. I got some tools here. Got a measuring tape. Got my ruler. And really big chalk. Huge. Different colors. And what else do we need? Well, this might take a while, so I got music. Okay, I'm gonna go at it. I'm gonna let the tape run, and I guess we'll see what it's like. Hopefully you can create this on a piece of paper and figure out what it's about. Bucka, 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 bucka.
You know the deal. This is me, though. Beast by Supremo for all of my people, Negroes and Latinos, and even the gringos. Yo, check it, one for Charlie Hustle, two for Steady Rock, three for the fourth coming live, future shot. It's five dimensions, six senses, seven firmaments of heaven to hell, 8 million stories to tell, nine planets faithfully keep in orbit with the probable tenth. The universe expands length, the body of my text possess extra strength, power lifted powerless, up out of this towering inferno, my ink so hot it burned through the journal. I'm blacker than midnight on Broadway and Myrtle. Hip hop passed all your tall social hurdles, like the nationwide projects, prison industry complex, working class poor, better keep your alarm set. Streets too loud to ever hear freedom ring. Say it back and wait to sleep. It's dangerous to dream, but your chain cats get they chabam. You dead now. Killing fields need blood to graze the cash cow. It's a numbers game, but shit don't add up somehow. Like I got 16 to 32 bars to rock it, but only 15% of profits ever seen my pockets. Like 69 billion in the last 20 years spent on national defense, but folks still live in fear. Like nearly half of America's largest cities is one quarter black. That's why they gave Ricky Ross all the crap. 16 ounces to a 20 more to a key, a 5 minute sentence hearing and you're no longer free. 40% of Americans own a cell phone, so they can hear everything that you say when you ain't home. I guess Michael Jackson was right, you are not alone. Rock your hard hat black as you in the terror dome. Full of hard niggas, large niggas, dice tumblers, young teens in prison greens facing life numbers. Crack mothers, crack babies and AIDS patients. Young bloods can't spell, but they can rock you a PlayStation. This new math is whipping motherfuckers ass. You wanna know how to rhyme, you better learn how to add. It's mathematics.
Mighty most depth.
It's simple mathematics. Check it out. I revolve around science.
What are we talking about here?
Mighty most depth.
Sorry, my handwriting sucks. And my forte is really bad. Not English.
What are we talking about here?
It's a lot harder writing with chalk than I thought. Okay, end of music. talk about this. The number you see there is called the natural numbers. Those are the first number set that us as human beings really grasped. Basically, it was counting from one all the way up as whole numbers. Basically going 1, 2, 3, 4, dot, 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 until infinity. But we had no concept of what infinity was thousands of years ago, hundreds of years ago, okay? The boundary between the natural numbers right there, going up to the whole numbers, that was the discovery of the number zero, but it wasn't really discovered because zero existed before. It was basically us getting smart enough to comprehend what zero meant. And we still don't comprehend it, actually. It was just finding something that didn't work out according to the rules that we knew before. So just imagine, thousands of years ago, there's a whole bunch of people sitting there in a village, okay? Assume that these people were farmers or sheep herders. Let's talk about sheep herding. Let's say they were sheep herders. Now these people sitting at the natural number set, just imagine them sitting in a bar talking together, okay? What would sheep farmers be talking about? They were talking about sheep, of course. So they sit around and, you know, one guy, John, asks Fred, "Fred, how many sheep do you have?" Fred goes, 2 sheep. Fred asks John, "How many sheep do you have?" John goes, "I'm richer than you. I have 5 sheep. You know, Alfred sits over down, and you know, they ask Alfred how many sheep he has. He goes, "I got 10 sheep, man. I'm the richest sheep herder there is." Now, some Joe Blow walks through the door, okay, comes and sits down at the table. Now, these guys want to size this guy out, right? And they go, "Hey, dude, how many sheep do you have?" And this guy goes, "0. Now, just imagine if you're living in a village and everybody's a sheep herder, and some dude walks in and goes, "I don't have any sheep, 0. Now, that's outside of the reality they would have been able to comprehend. If this guy had no sheep, then how the hell did he take care of his family? How did he feed himself? What in the world did he do if he didn't have any sheep? So that was a discovery, or us being able to comprehend that there was something outside of the reality that we knew, moving from the natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, to the whole number set, or the whole, to the whole numbers, which is 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., all the way up, okay? So the introduction of zero for us being able to comprehend, or us knowing that there was such a thing as zero, was a great breakthrough. It was huge, humongous. Even Einstein's problem, special relativity, relativity, zero is one of the biggest issues still facing mathematics. We cannot properly deal with zero. So we're still stuck partially between this boundary where we can't deal with it. The reason being is, as far as you're concerned, in high school, you cannot divide by zero. Because if you divide by zero, you get infinity. And we cannot grasp what infinity means, okay? So zero is one end of the spectrum. Actually, it's the pivot. You got infinity on one side, and you got negative infinity on the other side. If you divide by zero, you get both. I'll talk about these later, okay?